அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். திஸ் இஸ் ஜாஸ்லின். லைக் டுடே ஐம் கோயின் டு ஷோ யூ அபவுட் த லைக் ஐம் கோயின் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் சம் ஆஃப் த சேஃப்டி ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் விச் ஆர் அவைலபிள் இன் த இன்னோவா கிறிஸ்டா. சே ஏபிஎஸ் வித் இபிடி, இஎஸ்பி, ட்ராக்ஷன் கண்ட்ரோல் அண்ட் ஏர் பேக். ஓகே, ஸோ லைக் திஸ் இஸ் அ டாப் மாடல், 2.8Z மாடல். ஓகே, அண்ட் இட் ஹாஸ் பிளெண்டி சேஃப்டி ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் சச் அஸ் இஎஸ்பி, ட்ராக்ஷன் கண்ட்ரோல். ABS with EBD is standard across all variant of Innova Crysta, G, V and Z. So I'm going to explain all the features, what are the things which are there. So initially, so I'm just going inside the cabin. So, okay, fine. Like, just start the vehicle. Like, you can see the light, some kind of lights which you can see. I'll show you the, what are the things. ABS light, traction control, okay, then airbag light. Okay, so basically what is ABS? ABS is the anti-lock braking system. I mean, everyone knew about it, everyone knew what ABS. Okay, so but anyway, I'm just going to give you the basic thing. ABS is the anti-lock braking system. What happens is, like, whenever you drive a car, drive a two-wheeler or a four-wheeler, what happens, like, say example you're driving a two-wheeler, okay, and suddenly when a buffalo or anything comes in front of you, okay, so what you do, you apply the sudden braking. When you apply the sudden braking to the only the rear wheel, what happens, your wheel gets locked. Okay, the wheel gets locked, and when you steer your main, like when you steer your two-wheeler, you automatically, it tends to fall down. Okay, same case if in the case of car. In case of two-wheeler, the steering control is controlled independently by the brake. Like, a front brake is for the steering wheel and rear brake is for rear. Mostly people apply only the rear brake. Okay, so in case of car, when you apply sudden brake, what happens is, like, the front wheel gets, the brake is being directly applied to the front wheel, not the rear wheel. Each and every car starting from old generation, the brakes are applied to the front wheel. Okay, so when you apply the sudden brake, what happens, the wheel gets locked. In old Maruti 800, old Swift or whatever, basically non-ABS equipped car, okay, wheel gets locked. So when the wheel gets locked, what happens, you can't able to control the steering wheel. What happens, it won't move. You can't control, like, if you steer like this, the wheel gets, the vehicle may move this side or this side, depends based on the momentum. Okay, so the thing is, the primary thing is, like, without ABS, it's hard to braking. The wheel slippage and may lead to fatal accident. ABS, it can save you. Okay, and remember only, ABS is just an aid. It's not a primary thing for your safety of your life. Always drive carefully. Drive with a minimum speed. Ride the safety precaution speed as quoted by our government of India. Like 180, 100, depends on the locations. Just drive the safe speed. ABS is just an aid to save you. That's it. Okay, so this is what happens. So right now, I'm just going to explain how the ABS, what are the, where is the ABS motor, how the pressure is built up, and what happens when you apply the sudden brake and everything. I'm going to show you right now. Let me switch off the car. Okay, fine. Actually, I opened the boot. Okay, just to show you, these are the engine parts. You know, this is the engine and my battery, fuse, diesel filter, and power steering fluid. Okay, this is a radiator fan, coolant reservoir, then turbocharger. Okay, this is a what, air filter. Okay, and behind the air filter is the ABS motor. Okay, this is the ABS motor, and in the ABS motor, there will be inside a DC motor would be there. These are the four lines, the subsidiary lines. I don't know the exact name, what are the subs, I'm just giving, assuming the name as a subsidiary line. This is the main line from the reservoir, input line and the output line. The what happens when you apply the brake, this is a brake booster. You can see the disc kind of drum, that is a brake booster. There will be a diaphragm, it would be there. So when you apply the brake, it releases a kind of vacuum and gives you the more pressure. So that thing which pushes the, this is the brake fluid reservoir to fill the brake fluid. And this is the reservoir, it goes directly to the ABS motor. Okay, and output reservoir is connected to the ABS, it's a kind of closed circuit. Okay, to the reservoir, hydraulic reservoir. These are the subsidiary lines. Each line goes to the each wheel, front two wheels and rear two wheels. You can see this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each line goes to each wheel. Even I can show you the reservoir where it goes, and also each wheel is connected with the sensor. okay, you can see the top line. Top line is the reservoir line, bottom line is the sensor line. Okay, okay, each wheel is fitted with a sensors inside there. Inside this thing, inside, when you remove the wheel here, when you remove the brake, this is the drum brake, behind this there will be a sensor which detects the continuous motion of the wheel. So now coming to ABS, so what it does, say suddenly if anyone comes in front of your vehicle, you apply the sudden braking. What it does, the brakes are being applied to the brake booster. From the brake booster, it goes directly to the hydraulic, this pump reservoir. This pump reservoir, it's being connected to the ABS motor. So when the wheel tends to lock, okay, obviously when you apply the brake, so what it happens, there's a line which goes directly. So when the wheel, this car closing, when the wheel tends to lock, what happens? The sensor detects the wheel is locking. The sensor sends a signal to the ABS motor. Okay, this, what happened, the both sensors will be there during the braking action. The all the four sensors will be in action. Okay, so you can ask me like, why there are four sensors? Okay, when the brake is applied, only to the front wheel, right? So then why there are four sensors? Okay, coming to the point, this model has ABS, is fitted with the ABS with electronic brake force distribution. So that, like, when the brake is applied, the brake force is being distributed to all the four wheels. It depends on, say, it depends on the braking intensity, depends on the speed, and also to reduce the nose dive. Actually, nose dive is there, but in a minimum level. So when you apply the brake, the nose, you can experience a nose dive, and also the for the sudden immediate braking, and also to reduce the momentum. Momentum is like when the moving object suddenly gets stopped, it may experience a sudden kind of jerk because of the weight of the body. Okay, so in order to reduce those momentum, the electronic brake force distribution EBD is there. Okay, it depends on, like, 70% brake will be applied to the front wheel, 30% of brake will be applied to the rear wheel. If it's a sudden braking, if it's a medium braking, 50% pressure will be applied to the front wheel and the rear wheel. That is a brake force distribution. Okay. And everything, the primary mover is the ABS motor. So how it works? So when it turns, the wheel is locking, the front wheel, obviously, okay? When the front wheel tends to lock, okay? Well, what happens is, like, as I told you, 70% is applied only to the front wheel, 30% only applied to the rear wheel in case of a sudden braking. So obviously, the most of the braking feature is braking. When the slow speed, the braking is applied to the front wheel. So what it happens, when the wheel tends to lock, the sensor detects the wheel is locking and sends a signal to this motor. This motor, inside there's a DC motor will be there. DC motor, it pumps the fluid, the brake fluid from the hydraulic reservoir. The fluid gets pumped and the fluid is being sent to the wheel. Okay, the fluid, the pressure is being increased, rise. Actually, ABS works 7 times a second. 7 times a second, the brake pedal, the brake caliber, it holds the disc and release, holds and release into 7 times a second. Basically, the action happens in a millisecond. Okay, this is what happens in the ABS. Okay, same thing as I told you, ABS with EBD. That's the ABS with EBD is standard across all variant from G, V, and Z, Z model. Okay, and ESP. ESP is electronic stability program. Electronic stability program is like, electronic stability program or VSA, vehicle stability program, whatever may be, depends on the brand, they will name it as such, but the function is similar. What it does, like, when you steer the vehicle in a sudden steering, oversteering or understeer, what happens is, like, you may lose the control of your steering, your vehicle may go out of control. So in that case, so say if you are traveling in a highway, okay, and if you are taking a sharp right turn, at that time what happens is, like, your right wheel may tends to go left or something, it goes, okay. So what it is, in that case, the sensors which are available in the each wheel, it detects the wheel slippage, it is which wheel getting locked or which wheel it's losing the traction, it just applies the brake to that wheel. Okay, so in that case also, the ABS motor performs the thing. ABS motor is actually not, we can't say it's a ABS, it's a brake control motor, we can say, okay, safety motor, whatever may be. This motor builds up the pressure and sends the pressure to the particular wheel. There will be the inside what it would be, there is a solenoid, will be the electromechanical device is like, what happens in solenoid, when you apply the current, the valve opens,
extension and reduction. When you apply the current, it gets reduced, like due to magnetic field or whatever, it gets reduced. That size, that coil gets shrinked or extended. This is what happens in the inside. There will be mechanical, sorry, there will be around 12 solenoids will be there, I think so. I don't know exactly. There will be 12 solenoids will be there. Those solenoids, it depends on, it applies the pressure to the particular wheel. Okay, this is what happens in ESP. ESP also, like it, the basic thing, it gives you the control of steering. Okay, and also one more thing, so like always drive carefully. Is ESP just an aid? In uncertainable circumstances, you may lose a traction and you may lose in a fatal accident also. Always drive carefully. This is just an aid. Actually, I've tried operating ESP like in a background. I just made a circle with a car, like full steering and full like given an accelerator, and the wheel and the vehicle starts to spin. At that time, the car tends to lose the control, and ESP was in action. Okay, in case of the traction control, next, the traction control. Traction control is like, while you're accelerating, this is a rear wheel drive vehicle, while you're accelerating in a sloped surface, sloped or a water surface, watery surface, whatever maybe, you may lose the traction and the wheel tends to spin, right? So when you are in incline, when it's a sharp incline, and the ground is like full of gravels or sands or sand or whatever, and when you step on an accelerator, what happens? The wheel loses the traction and it starts to spin. So when the wheel starts to spin during the traction, what happens? The sensor detects the spin and it sends a signal to the ABS motor. ABS motor, what it does, it again sends a sense signal and sends the high pressure to the particular fluid line, to the particular wheel, applies the brake and release. So it gives some traction while braking, it gives some traction to the ground, and then release, and then while braking, it gives some traction to the ground, so that it takes in a fraction of milliseconds. Okay, so in that case, it gives the traction to the wheel, and thereby you can move on. This is what happens, and this is the traction control. And again is the airbag. Innova Crysta comes with the three airbags as a standard across all variants. G, V and Z has three airbags as a standard. What are the airbags? All driver airbag, passenger airbag, knee airbag, these are standard across all variants. Okay, in the Z variant alone, you have that this airbag, I don't know the exact name, this thing, this side, when you're in an accident crash, it will force you here, right? This side, when you force it here, so in case of the here on airbag is there, this seat airbag would be there, and curtain airbags, it's okay. 1, 2, 3, this four, this side only, where 4, 5, that side, 5, then curtain airbags. You can see the SRS airbag symbol would be there. Here it is, you can see SRS airbag symbol, right? Curtain airbags, total curtain airbags will be there. Airbag will be a nylon, nylon cloth. I think sodium azide reaction. I think so. I'm not clear. Sodium azide, no, or sodium azide or nitrogen azide. Whatever, maybe I'm not clear in that. NaN2. Yes, sodium azide. Yeah, NaN2. I think. Yes, the reaction is a sodium azide, okay, NaN2 reaction. So what happens in the airbag, there will be an airbag module will be there, which will be operated by the 12 volt signal, okay. So sensors would be available present here, somewhere here. I don't know the exact location of sensors. Might be here or somewhere, might be here, this side and that side, and side sensors would be there also. Side sensors is there. Okay, so what it does, when the sensor detects the crash impact, sensors activates the 12 volt signal from the battery to the airbag module. When the airbag, inside the airbag module, sodium azide would be there. So when it's being triggered by the electrical signal, it gets deployed, it gets reacted to the sodium salts and nitrogen air. Okay, so the nitrogen air is used to expand the nylon bag. Okay, that like instead would be nylon bag would be there, like a kind of a brown, some nylon bag would be there. So the nitrogen gets inflates that bag, and with the emission of the sodium salt. So that whenever you see the vehicle with the airbag be deployed, you can see YouTube videos like that. So kind of it emits some powder also. That powder is nothing but a sodium salt. Okay, and nitrogen air. Nitrogen has been released to inflate the airbag. And also mind one thing. Whenever you place your child in the front seat, remember to switch off the airbag. Okay, so what is the impact which causes, like see, I'll show you.
there's a chance you can switch off the airbag. You can, if it's a case of smart key, remove the manual key. Okay, remove the manual key from the smart key system and just make it just insert inside this module, and you can easily switch off the airbag. In case of a manual, that jack and knife key, you can insert the key and you can switch off the airbag, like turn off the airbag. Like when the child is being seated here, what happens, like when the airbag is being deployed, it causes a huge impact to the child. As I told you, the nitrogen air is being released in a high huge pressure with the sodium salts particles or whatever may be, so it may cause a huge impact. So whenever the child is being seated, like in a family, like one small child and a wife will be there. Okay, so wife, husband will be there. So while driving, make sure to switch them back to the rear seat, or else if they are seated in the front seat, make sure to switch off the airbag. Okay, and also if you switch off the airbag, you may lose the safety for you also, so mind that. And also, airbag, it won't deploy unless you wear a seatbelt. Okay, seatbelt is mandatory so that airbag gets deployed. The reason behind this, like if the airbag gets deployed and you aren't wearing a seatbelt, say for example, what happens is, like the, as I told you, the pressure developed by the airbag is such a huge thing. Okay, it gets expanded like this, and in case of sudden crash, you may force from here to here. Okay, so if here to here, and if you aren't wearing seatbelt, the impact of airbag on your face would be much higher, such that it may damage totally your face and it may lead to death also. So in that case, if you wear the seatbelt, it may reduce the contact of airbag and you, and thereby just giving the protection of your face. Okay, so always make sure to switch, buckle up your seats while on your car drive, especially for the first row passenger. For all passengers, it's mandatory to wear the seatbelt for safety purpose. I can tell you, if you are in your seatbelt, your face get heated towards this wood, okay, towards here, okay, your head may get crashed towards the roof, okay. So always make sure to buckle your seats, okay, buckle seats up for the extra safety, whenever you are in a car, okay. That's it.